The Bakehouse Art Complex is a non-for-profit organization. We've been around since 1984. We are a nonprofit organization that provides affordable studio space for working, mid-career, and emerging artists in Miami. We've been here, like I said, since 1984. We provide affordable studio spaces, exhibition opportunities, and also educational development. In the 1920s and 30s, this facility actually used to be the American Bakeries Company, and they actually used to bake really delicious breads and pastries and whatnot in here. It was abandoned about 20 years later, and then it was picked up by the artist who founded the place in the early 80s, and then they developed it into what it is today. Currently, we have 68 artists in residence, and we have over 70 studios. Some artists occupy more than one studio. One of the big criteria, actually, during our application process is we look at the application and we say, will this add anything to the experience of a visitor at the Bakehouse? You know, we don't want to have every studio filled with, you know, contemporary painters. We want everything, sculptors, painters, fiber artists, performance artists, we have everything. And I think one of the reasons we're lucky enough to have that is because we have facilities for each of those mediums. We have a dark room, we have a print room. So all of those kind of specific rooms that we have are very hard to find outside of the education setting. You know, the last time that you see that really is in college. So artists really get excited and they're able to, even if it's not their medium, they're able to kind of experiment. You know, we've had a lot of painters come in here and start using the print room and start kind of crossing over and integrating new medium into their work. So it's a great place. It's a great place for artists to be, to develop, to collaborate. It's nice.
Et je suis venu ici parce que j'ai ouvert en 1972 une agence de publicité en France, advertising agency. And after 25 years. I was tired to do that. Et je suis désolé, je mélange l'anglais et le français, mais bon, c'est très bien. Et à partir de là, j'ai dit, je veux faire autre chose. J'ai toujours fait de l'art dans ma vie, depuis l'âge de 5 ans. J'ai toujours fait de la peinture. Et donc, j'en avais marre de faire de la publicité, donc j'ai arrêté mon business. Et on est venu s'installer ici avec ma femme et mon fils, d'ailleurs. En France, beaucoup d'artistes, il y a beaucoup d'ego chez les artistes. Un ego grand comme ça. Et il n'y a pas le même climat qu'ici. Je trouve qu'ici, au Bakehouse en particulier, chacun a son propre style, son propre art, mais il n'y a pas de concurrence, il n'y a pas de compétition entre nous. Il y a une très bonne ambiance ici dans le Bakehouse. C'est ce qui m'a plu. Ça fait 12 ans que je suis ici au Bakehouse. Je l'ai vu évoluer, j'ai vu changer, j'ai vu. Voilà. Wynwood, 12 years ago, was non fréquentable. C'était pas fréquentable. C'était pas dangereux, mais c'était pas ce que c'était. Et le Bakehouse en particulier, parce qu'on est quand même un peu écarté de Wynwood ici. On est au bout de Wynwood. Et je me souviens, personne ne venait ici. J'avais des amis qui habitaient à South Beach. Ils me disaient, jamais on traverse, on ne vient pas ici, on ne veut pas venir là, parce que c'est dangereux. Je n'ai jamais éprouvé de danger ici. Enfin bon. Et petit à petit, tout ça a évolué, a beaucoup changé. Le Bakehouse a beaucoup changé. Wynwood bon, est venu ce qu'il est. Et maintenant, on a. Il y a pléthore d'artistes. Il y a des artistes partout ici. À Miami, il y a des artistes partout. Je dis en plaisantant, il y a une dizaine d'années, quand on allait dans les parties, on rencontrait que des réalisateurs. Maintenant, on ne rencontre que des artistes. C'est vrai. Il y a beaucoup d'artistes à Miami. Alors qu'il y a 12 ans, il n'y avait pas beaucoup d'artistes. Et il n'y avait pas beaucoup de galeries. Il y avait Bernice, Stenbaum, il y avait quelques galeries à Damar, des gens qui sont toujours là. Mais alors que maintenant, il y a pléthore de galeries, pléthore d'artistes, des galeries qui ouvrent, qui ferment. C'est Wynwood. Mais ça me plaît beaucoup. Beaucoup parce que c'est un bouillonnement artistique qui se fait. Il y a de tout, du bon, du mauvais, du moins bon. chacun trouve son, chacun fait son jugement et chacun peut faire son marché, il n'y a pas de problème. Voilà. Et je trouve que c'est très bien pour Miami. Voilà.
We actually started doing the second Saturdays when Wynwood started doing the second Saturdays. We figured that we were a little bit off the beaten path, and you know, Wynwood is just, it's so booming on second Saturdays. There's so many people. It's really hard to park. So I know that when I go out, I want to park once, get out of my car and visit as much as possible. For us, we're off, you know, we're a few blocks away. We're not really in the heart of Wynwood. So we decided that in our best interest to move our opening receptions to the night before, to the second Friday of every month. And it's been wildly successful. We've got between 200 and 400 people here every single opening. We get people here that come at 7 and they don't leave until 10. Because you go to the openings and you grab your glass of wine, you do a once around the gallery, you say hi to the people that you know, and then you go and you move on to the next gallery. And that's what makes it so much fun, is because you're able to like speed date through all of those galleries, you know what I mean? We change it every single month. We've been trying to break that reputation and change that reputation and that vision that the community has of the Bakehouse. And I think in the last 6 months, we've made a tremendous, tremendous leap in the right direction. We've gotten coverage from NBC6, finally exposure from Miami Herald, Miami New Times. I think we're getting there. And I think in direct relation with the Wynwood Arts District, as that grows, the Bakehouse has to, and that's where we come. We're kind of like the feeding factory, you know? We have the artists, we have the local talent that feeds those galleries. And I think as that grows, we have to. It's gotta be a direct ratio, it has to. We have to be able to flourish with that. And I think with our new implementation of a jury process for the applications, with, you know, we've actually even added some studios recently. We got a $475,000 grant from the county 2 years ago, 3 years ago? I think it was 3 years ago. We got air conditioning, we got a new roof, we got painted. We're trying to make the facility look presentable to show that we have changed. It's a new Bakehouse and we're ready to grow with the district.
I think Wynwood has the brightest future of all the areas in the downtown corridor. I think it's because we have the spaces to do very interesting, eclectic things. Just this morning, we showed a typical warehouse to a group out of New York that has a high-end sneaker shop, and they want to do one here. We just opened a new cinema house here called O Cinema. It's an independent and foreign film cinema house, only 50 seats, directly across the street from the Rubel Art Collection. We have incredible art collections that are world-renowned, like the Rubels and like Marty Margolese' collection and the Scholes and Dela Cruz up in the Design District. So we have 75 art galleries at the moment in this neighborhood. We have 24 really great food and beverage outlets in the neighborhood and more coming. So I think the future looks very bright for the area, and it's going to need more live-work lofts like we built in 2005. We built Wynwood Lofts, and in 2001 we did the Terminal Fabrics factory building into lofts. We have tremendous demand for more of that kind of space, but this will be one of the most interesting parts of Miami, without a doubt.